Hi, everyone, and welcome to English for You. I'm Erin.
And I'm Elsie.
Elsie, one of my favorite things to tell people at home about Taiwan is the Yanshui Fireworks Festival in Tainan County.
Tainan 的盐水风炮. Have you been to it?
I have, and it's crazy. There are fireworks going off everywhere.
Do you know why this festival started?
I think so.Back in the 19th century, people around the area were suffering from a disease, right?
Yeah, the story is that people were dying of cholera, 霍乱, and medicine for it wasn't around to help them yet. So they prayed to 关圣帝君 to help them get rid of the disease.
Okay, so then a general led the god, how do you say it? 关帝.
关圣帝君
Okay, 关圣帝君
Good.
Through the town, and they set off fireworks along the way. And soon after, the cholera was gone. Now they do it every year.
That's it. Why did you bring this up, though?
Well, we're going to learn about a different disease today called typhoid, and about one woman in particular who had this disease. It's quite an interesting story.
Great. Let's get started.
Reading. The Curious Case of Typhoid Mary. Mary Malone, or Typhoid Mary, was infamous for spreading a dangerous disease in New York City, U.S., in 1907. What's interesting is that she never exhibited any of the disease's symptoms herself.In fact, she was the country's first known case of a disease's healthy carrier. In 1906, Charles Warren, a wealthy banker, rented a summer vacation house for his family. However, 6 of the 11 people there contracted typhoid during their holiday. George Soper, a civil engineer, investigated the cause of the outbreak.He traced the disease back to Mary Malone, a former cook for the Warren family. Further examination showed that typhoid outbreaks had followed Malone from job to job since 1900. One girl had even died from typhoid. Soper handed the case over to New York's health department. When Dr. Josephine Baker, who was calling the shots,discovered Malone cooking for a new family, she insisted that Malone be quarantined. Malone was taken to Riverside Hospital on North Brother Island and forced to live alone. She was held against her will for 3 years.
All right, let's find out who the person who had this disease is. The first line of our article says, Mary Mallon, or Typhoid Mary, was infamous for spreading a dangerous disease in New York City, U.S. in 1907.
我们以前学过呢 famous 这个形容词是出名的，而且是正面的意义。那如果我们在字首加上 in,Infamous, 它是一个形容词，代表是恶名昭彰的。这边的出名就是负面的出名哦。Why was Mary Mallon or Typhoid Mary, 伤寒玛丽, infamous? Because she spread a dangerous disease.
Okay, so let's find out what this disease is. Disease is a noun, and it's a serious illness that can hurt anything that lives, including animals and plants.Now, sometimes diseases can take a long time to cure, and some can't be cured at all. Here's an example using the word disease. Lamar's grandmother suffers from Alzheimer's disease. It affects her brain, and she has trouble remembering things.
Disease 这个名词呢，有指感染导致的疾病。那刚刚 Aaron 老师提到的 Alzheimer's disease 就是所谓的阿兹海默症，也就是我们所谓的老年痴呆症。那文章中，伤寒玛丽在1907年的时候，在纽约散播一种疾病 ，typhoid 是所谓的伤寒。Was she spreading it on purpose or she didn't know anything about it?
Let's find out the answer to that question. Here in the article, it says, what's interesting is that she, that's Mary, never exhibited any of the disease's symptoms herself. Now, when you exhibit something, it's a verb. Exhibit is a verb here. It means that you clearly show or clearly display that you have a particular feeling or ability or quality. Okay, here's an example. Penelope exhibited a talent for music at a young age.
Exhibit 这个动词呢是表露或是展现出，也就是 show 这个字。另外呢，它有展出或陈列某物品的意思。而物品展出的地方呢，就是所谓的展览或是展览会，我们说 exhibition.
Okay, so...Mary Mallon never had, she never showed, she never exhibited any of these typhoid symptoms, even though she had the disease.
Right, symptom 是名词症状的意思。文章中说到呢，虽然伤寒玛丽得到了伤寒，但却没有显示出任何伤寒的症状。But Aaron, what、mm-hmm. are the symptoms for typhoid?
Well, some of the less serious ones are having a poor appetite. That means you're not very hungry, getting headaches, and just other kinds of aches and pains.
所以除了胃口不好、头痛之外，还有 high fever, 高烧和 diarrhea, 腹泻等等之类的 symptoms, 症状。
Okay, now there's a special name for someone like Mary Mallon, someone who has a disease but doesn't show any symptoms. Here in the article it says, in fact, she was the country's first known case of a disease's healthy carrier.
Healthy 是健康的 ，carrier 这边代表的是带源者，所以 healthy carrier 健康带源者，也就是自己不会染病，但是会把病传染给其他人。
Now they, I do want to point out that they did find more healthy carriers later, but Mary Mallon was the only one who has such an interesting case. So they do.Now that our science is so advanced, that there are lots of healthy carriers out there, but this was the first known case of one. Okay, so let's find out what is so interesting about her case. Here in the article, we kind of have a bit of a story to go behind Mary Mallon's case. It says, in 1906, Charles Warren, a wealthy banker, rented a summer vacation house for his family.Now, wealthy is an adjective, and it describes someone who has a lot of money or property or other kind of wealth or riches. As an example, we could say, the wealthy woman decided to donate some of her money to charity.
Wealthy 其实就是 rich 这个形容词的意思，富有的、富裕的。那如果我们把字尾的 y 拿掉 ，wealth 这个名词指的是财富。那文章中提到的这一位 wealthy banker 富有的银行家，他 rented a house for his family.
That's right. And when you rent something, here rent is a verb, you pay money, often month by month, sometimes by hour, sometimes in other time periods.You pay money to live in a place that does not belong to you or to use some other kind of goods or services that belong to someone else. For example, we could say Odette pays 17,000 NT dollars every month to rent this apartment.
Rent 这个动词呢，指的是租用。那另外它还可以当名词来解释，是房租或租金。And what happened after he rented his house for his family?
Okay, well, let's find out. Here in the article it says, however, 6 of the 11 people there contracted typhoid during their holiday. Now, when you contract a disease, contract here is a verb, you catch the disease.
Contract 在文章中呢，当的是动词使用，是感染疾病的意思。那它当名词的时候呢，可以指的是合约或契约。So there were 6 people that contracted typhoid.
That's right. Okay, so 6 people in this vacation house have typhoid. That's a good way to ruin your summer vacation. And... it's not great. So they wanted to find out why so many people got typhoid there. So they hired someone to look into it. Here it says, George Soper, a civil engineer, investigated the cause of the outbreak. Now, who is George Soper?
George Soper, 他是一位 civil engineer, 也就是土木工程师。他 investigated the cause.
Right, now investigate here is a verb, and when you investigate, you try to find the truth about how something happened, such as a crime, an accident, or a scientific problem. For example, we could say, after all the fish in the lake died, the scientists investigated the cause of their death. They wanted to know why the fish died.
Investigate 这个动词呢是调查查明，我们也可以用一个片语叫做 look into 来代替。那名词呢则是 investigation， 像是我们知道的美国联邦调查局。The FBI, 它的全名就是 the Federal Bureau of Investigation.
I have a question.
Yeah.
Does Taiwan have something like an FBI?
Yeah, I think so.
Okay.
We do have it. Okay, so this civil engineer investigated the cause of the outbreak,、mm-hmm. 也就是调查这件事情的起因。And what does outbreak mean?
Well, that is a good question, Elsie. And this is kind of a difficult word.But it's interesting because if you change it around a little bit and say break out, we're actually going to learn about that a little bit later with the same kind of meaning.
Okay,、mm-hmm. 所以呢 outbreak 一个字合在一起它是名词爆发。那如果我们把 outbreak 分开再交换位置就变成了 break out 这个动词片语咯。那等一下我们的文章也会提到这个片语。Alright, back to the article.、
Mm-hmm.
Did George Soper find anything when he was investigating the cause of the outbreak?
He sure did. In fact, we learn here in the article, he traced the disease back to Mary Mallon, a former cook for the Warren family. Now, when you trace something, trace here is a verb, and when you trace something, you try to find the origin or the beginning of something, which means you often have to look at things in the past. Now, because of this, we often use the verb trace with the preposition back, because you're going back into the past. Here's an example. The fire chief traced the cause of the fire back to a lit cigarette.
Trace 这个动词是查明、追踪。Trace A back to B， 将 A 这件事情追溯到 B 这个时间、地方或是人的身上。George Soper 发现 Mary Mallon， 也就是 Warren 家的前任厨师，跟这个疾病的爆发有关联。
And there's Mary Mallon, or Typhoid Mary. Now remember, she has typhoid, but she's a healthy carrier, so she doesn't really get sick from it. But other people do. In fact, the article goes on to say, further examination showed that typhoid outbreaks had followed Mallon from job to job since 1900. So that's about a 6 or 7 year period by this point. Now, here's another interesting thing to note. The bacteria that causes typhoid is actually killed when food is heated or cooked.So the people who investigated Mary Mallon thought that she actually was spreading this disease through a frozen dish made with peaches and ice cream. Now, because it wasn't cooked, the bacteria didn't die. And it was one of her most famous dishes, which is how so many people got sick from her.
所以进一步的检查发现 Mallon 每换一个工作那里就会有伤寒的爆发。可是食物被加热之后细菌是会死掉的，怎么还会传染给别人呢？原来是因为 Mallon 的 specialty 拿手菜是水蜜桃和冰淇淋做成的，不必加热。 Wow, so all because of this frozen dish.
That's what they think, yeah. Maybe there were some other dishes too, but I think that was her main way of spreading typhoid. Okay, so we know now that Mary Mallon has been spreading typhoid for years, but it gets worse. Here in the article, it says one girl had even died from typhoid. So that's bad news, but I think it's lucky that there weren't more. And in fact, actually, so many people were getting sick from Mary. She's lucky that not more people died, but so many people were getting sick that it was too big for Soper to do this work on his own anymore. So here's what he did. It said Soper handed the case over to New York's health department. Now, when you hand something over to someone, you give them the power or responsibility to do something because you can't or you don't want to be in charge of it anymore. For example, we could say, Igor handed the business over to his daughter when he retired.
Hand something over to 代表的是将某物移交警方或当局来处理。Soper 将这个案件交由纽约的公共卫生部门来处理。And who took over the case?
Okay, well, we know it went to the New York Health Department, but there was a certain person who was in charge. So let's talk about them. Here it says, when Dr. Josephine Baker, who was calling the shots, discovered Mallon cooking for a new family, she insisted that Mallon be quarantined. Now, calling the shots is a fun phrase that we're going to learn about. It's today's shortcut for you. So we're going to take a quick break to hear more about it now.
Shortcut for you.
Are you free this evening? We can go to the movies.
Sorry, I can't. I have to help my family cook some food for our party tomorrow.
That's too bad. Well, at least you can have fun bossing your family around. I know you're the best cook.
No way. My mom calls the shots in our kitchen.
Calls the shots? Does she need to call the doctor to get a shot?
No, not that kind of shot. To call the shots means to control what people do or what happens.
I understand now. Call the shots means 当家做主发号司令。
Yes.
I'm glad I don't need to call the shots at my job. My boss is always so stressed out.
Yes, I wouldn't want to be in charge either.
所以说呢，接管这个案件的 Dr. Josephine Baker 发现 Mallon 当时还继续在工作，继续帮家庭煮饭。She then insisted that Mallon be quarantined. 当某人 insist 坚持 demand 要求 suggest 建议或者是 recommend 推荐他人做某事的时候 that 子句当中的助动词 should 会被省略。所以我们呢会看到原形动词直接出现。For example, my friend recommends that I should try this new restaurant. 我的朋友推荐我去试试这家新的餐厅。That 子句当中的 should 省略之后就会变成 My friend recommends that I try this new restaurant. 文章中的句子 She then insisted that Mallon be quarantined 因为要带出被动所以我们看到了原形 be 动词出现之后再加上 quarantined 这个第三态的动词。
Okay, so the investigators are following Mallon from the Warren family to a new family, but now that they think she's making people sick, they don't know for sure yet. They think they do want her to be quarantined to see if people stop getting sick.
Quarantine 就是动词隔离的意思，所以文章说到这位 doctor 他坚持 Mallon 应该要被隔离。
Okay, so let's find out what happened next. Here it says Mallon was taken to Riverside Hospital on North Brother Island and forced to live alone. Now, here's an interesting thing. North Brother Island is a small island in New York's East River. It's actually surrounded by the city. So she could see the city, but she just couldn't get there.
North Brother Island.北兄弟岛它位于纽约的东河上面文中提及的 Riverside Hospital 是当时用来隔离传染病患的 医院 So poor Melon.
Mm-hmm, not great. Okay, so we know she's confined to North Brother Island here. Now, here it also says she was held against her will for 3 years. Now, the phrase against one's will has a special meaning. If someone makes another person do something against their will, that person does not want to do that thing, but they have no choice because they do not have the power to stop it or say no. For example, the politicians made these people leave their homes against their will because they wanted to build a road where their houses were.
Against 是违背的意思，那 will 这边当名词用，指的是意志。Against one's will 违背意志的。虽然 Melon 不想，但是他还是在那里被关了三年之久。Did Melon try to do anything to get herself out of the hospital?
I'm sure she did, but Elsie, we don't have time to answer your question today. We'll learn more about Melon's interesting case in day 2 of our article, so we'll find out more tomorrow. For now, we're going to go straight to our 4U chat, so stay tuned.All right, today's For You chat question today is all about Mary Mallon and kind of what the government did to her. So our question is, do you think governments should have the right to quarantine healthy carriers? Why or why not?
I agree, because even though they're healthy carriers, they still could infect others.
Mm-hmm.
And governments...can't guarantee that all healthy carriers would stay at home or in a certain place by themselves.
Okay.
But I think governments need to protect their human rights at the same time.
Yeah, it's a very tricky question because if you're not protecting human rights, you're going to get in a lot of trouble.
Yeah.
And because, you know, Mary didn't realize she was doing anything wrong. You know, maybe she thought she was innocent. She didn't understand medicine or how typhoid worked or anything like that. So she didn't realize why she was being kind of put in this island by herself, I guess.
So do you think it's proper to do that?
I think if you follow certain conditions doing it, I think it's okay, but It has to be done properly if you're going to do it.
So governments need to be really careful.
Yes. Yeah. So an interesting question for you guys to talk about there. No opinion is wrong, but make sure you research your facts before you argue them. Okay. Well, we have to say goodbye today. For English for You, I'm Erin.
And I'm Elle. Say goodbye.
The Curious Case of Typhoid Mary.Mary Malone, or Typhoid Mary, was infamous for spreading a dangerous disease in New York City, U.S., in 1907. What's interesting is that she never exhibited any of the disease's symptoms herself. In fact, she was the country's first known case of a disease's healthy carrier. In 1906, Charles Warren, a wealthy banker,rented a summer vacation house for his family. However, 6 of the 11 people there contracted typhoid during their holiday. George Soper, a civil engineer, investigated the cause of the outbreak. He traced the disease back to Mary Malone, a former cook for the Warren family. Further examination showed that typhoid outbreaks...had followed Malone from job to job since 1900. One girl had even died from typhoid. Soper handed the case over to New York's health department. When Dr. Josephine Baker, who was calling the shots, discovered Malone cooking for a new family, she insisted that Malone be quarantined. Malone was taken to Riverside Hospital on North Brother Island,and forced to live alone. She was held against her will for 3 years.
Vocabulary Review.
Disease. The doctor told her patient that he had a disease, but that it wasn't serious. Exhibit. Ted's been exhibiting some signs of stress lately. Maybe he should take a break from work. Wealthy. My wealthy aunt takes us sailing on her boat every summer. Rent. Let's rent bicycles. It only costs $100 NT for 3 hours. Investigate. The teacher opened the door to investigate the sound he'd heard outside the class. Trace.I traced the bad smell back to the kitchen. You forgot to take out the trash.